What's going on, Port fans? Welcome back to another video on my channel. And today we're going to be giving you a bit of an update on the AFL trade period so far and see exactly where Port Adelaide stand in terms of certain trades and certain players that are happening at the moment. We're going to look into the Dougal Howard situation, the Orazio Fantasia situation, and other aspects of the trade period that Port Adelaide could be targeting. And we'll get to the bottom of it and see exactly what Port Adelaide are doing in the 2019 trade period. So let's get straight into it and see exactly what's going on. Well, it's been a pretty quiet start to the AFL trade period in general. A couple of pick swaps. There's been obviously the Tim Kelly trade from Geelong to West Coast. But the main thing we're here to focus on is Port Adelaide's cards that we're currently showing and exactly what we are thinking about doing. And at the moment, I think majority of us fans have no bloody idea what Port Adelaide are contemplating in terms of picks and exactly what trades are going to go down. First of all, we know about Dougal Howard's situation. He's been in the media for quite a few weeks now and under consideration whether or not he'll be targeted as trade bait or other clubs are circling and all that. But as now it's come out that essentially Port Adelaide told him, you know what? We see you as a forward. Dougal's come back and said, look, I'm preferably a better defender, but I'll do everything I can to become the best forward I can be. And then within a week, Jason Cripps, the list manager, and I'm sure the whole football department made this decision to say, look, Dougal, we see you as a forward. It's within the best interest of yourself and the club that if you want to, you can go look elsewhere. And he's done that. He's gone to North Melbourne. He's gone to Essendon. St Kilda have all been circling, and it's come out now that his preferred destination to go if traded is St Kilda. And look, to be honest, I'm more than likely it's going to happen. And that's unfortunate for a player that's 23 years old, has a ceiling that is through the roof. It's a massive prospect, and we're throwing away young talent. So versatile, so quick on his feet, skillful. He can play back, he can play forward, he can play in the ruck. A 200-centimetre versatile player is like the epitome of perfection in terms of how a player can play. He's tall and he's athletic, and we're throwing him away for a first-round pick simply because there's a little bit of a disagreement for him to be a preferred forward than he is a defender. For me personally, I don't see that being the main reason. I think there's a lot more under the rock than we anticipate here, and I think something could be brewing, and I really hope the club has a valid reason as to why. Not the club. The list and football departments. List management has been woeful. It's been very questionable. Last year's trade period was fantastic. We got some young kids out of it. I think it went really well with the way we wanted to go and sort of in terms of the direction that Kenny wanted to make and the change we wanted to make as a football club. We've done that. But now to come back into this year's trade period, to be selecting certain players that are part of that future and that future build, to be like, nah, I don't see you part of this. Off your trot. Doesn't make sense. Nothing of this makes sense. And I think Dougal Howard's probably feeling the same thing. He doesn't want to leave this club. He's very happy at this club. He never, ever expected to leave this football club under this sort of circumstance. And for him now to come out, and his management to come out and say it was a very mature conversation. I don't think it was a mutual agreement. I think there was definitely more to it than just, you can't play back, we want you to play forward. There's a lot more to it than that. I think Port Adelaide actually being a bit, I don't know if lazy is the right word, but they're being unorganised. You know, if you want a key forward, go out and get a key forward. Or build one within. We've got a couple of prospects. Todd Marshall's there. You got the likes of Hayes and Laddams that can play forward, and they're developing as young ruckmen. Lysak can play forward. Main man, Charlie Dixon. Develop one through the draft. You know, I think they're just being unorganised and saying, look, we'll just use Dougal and we'll make it up as we go. He's a defender. You're supposed to build your team around your defence. You build it around the solid rocks that are down back, your fullback, your centre-half back, that floating defender that Cleary, Jonas and Howard could be. Cleary, the fullback, the lockdown defender. Dougal, the centre-half back who can run and carry the footy. Tom Jonas, who's the skipper. He's the leadership down there. He's the floater and he can play tall or small. it doesn't make sense. To continue on from that, you go to look at the other side where we're targeting Orazio, a small forward. He's creative. He's got skill. He's got the ability to score 40-plus goals in a season, no worries, if his body stays fit. We're targeting a bloke who's having surgery in the off-season, won't be back till halfway through pre-season. And he's come out and said just today that he wants to stay a Bomber. To me, I think we put all our eggs in that Orazio basket. I don't see us going after anyone else. There's been rumours about Matthew Allen from West Coast, who's this versatile forward. Don't know. I don't think there's been much planning going into this besides let's stack up on draft picks and go for it. No excuses. We're not getting rid of pick 10. Got pick 29 to use as a little bit of bait to see what we can get. We're also trading Ryder. We're also trading Sam Gray. We're trying to. Then we've got a bit of bait with Sam Powell-Pepper, who, by the way, now that Essendon aren't getting rid of Orazio and he's staying, I effectively can take off Sam Powell-Pepper's name off the trade list because I think he'll stay now because he was the one that was going to be used in that trade. And at the moment, 4 days into the trade period, I don't think Port Adelaide are going to be involved in much more than a Dougal Howard trade and maybe a West Coast trade with Matthew Allen. Maybe a few future picks. A few trade picks. It baffles me that this is a scenario we're currently in after having what I'd call a pretty successful trade period in 2018. To come into 2019, we know the areas we need to improve in. We need a key position forward. We need a little small crafty forward. And we need speedy midfielders. We haven't put our hat in any ring. We haven't targeted anyone specifically besides Orazio. And even then, we were like, well, we don't know what's going on. We've sort of winged it. And there's no planning to this. It's a very strange strategy to come into a trade period. And we've got picks 10 and 29. It's like we didn't want to do much, but put a few names out there, see what we can get. You know, Ryder was that one. Offloading him, salary cap expenses, that will release a bit of tension there. Sam Gray, not quite what we're wanting at the moment. Let's send him off. And then for Dougal Howard, it just doesn't make sense. And at the moment, us as Oilers fans would be confused about this current strategy of this trade period. And to be 4 days in and having this conversation, yeah, baffling. But let me know what you guys think in the comments below. What do you think of the Dougal situation? What do you think of the Orazio Fantasia situation? Did we really want him? Or was this just a whole media build-up that we weren't expecting? We actually expected for him to come. And I was expecting him to come. I was like, all right, well, I'll take Orazio. I rate him. I rate him as a footballer when fit. But we still got 5 more days left of this trade period. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be very interesting to see exactly what plans we have in place. We have, obviously, the Friday and then the weekend to reconsider our options. And then we have 3 days of let's go at it. I think we need to, unless we've got something brewing behind the scenes that we aren't aware of, or no one's aware of, then I think F is already imprinted on the report card for this trade period. Especially if Dougal Howard goes, which I hope he doesn't, but I suspect the deal will get done, especially with St Kilda having picks 12 and 18 now with their trade with GWS, giving them pick 6. I think they'll send off pick 12 and a future first-round pick for Fremantle's Brad Hill. They'll send pick 18 to us, and unfortunately we'll be in that position where, well, let's just take it. So we'll have 2 first-round picks. It's going to be a fascinating few days for sure. Let me know in the comments below what you're thinking, Port fans, about the current trade situation. I'd love to hear them. Thanks so much for watching this little update for the trade period. I look forward to seeing what you guys think and what eventuates over the coming days. My name is Anthony. Make sure you subscribe to the channel for plenty more Port Adelaide content. And as always, count the pen.